Welcome to this installation guide for the Franke Omni 4-in-1 tap. I'll take you through every step of the process, and in this video, we'll cover preparation, how to install each component, and finally, how to change the filter. The Omni 4-in-1 tap system consists of three main components: the tap, the boiler, and the water filter. Before you start the installation, you should check that the mains water pressure is between 1.5 and 5 bar. Any higher, and you may need to fit a pressure reducing valve to protect the unit. It's also important to check that both the mains water and the electricity supply are turned off. Step 1. Install the tap. The first step is to install the Omni tap itself. This will make it easier to plan the space for the boiler. You'll need to drill a standard 35mm hole into the work surface. But before you do, check there's enough room for the tap handles when they're in the fully open position. Once that's done, you can feed the hoses through and position the tap. The fully reversible nature of Omni means that you can position it for either left or right-handed operation. Slide the gasket and the clamp plate over the hoses and the two studs at the base of the tap. Then, using the supplied box spanner, screw on the two clamp nuts, checking the final tap alignment before securing firmly. Now it's time to plan the cabinet layout. Just remember that the boiler must be upright. There should be access to the filter units for future changes, and that there is sufficient space for all the connections, including 80mm at the top. Step 3. The plumbing. Both a hot and cold water supply is required, and the cold should be teed off so that the water filter gets its own supply. It's this supply that should have the stop valve on it to make for easier filter changes. Connecting the hot and cold hoses is simple, thanks to the innovative nut runner devices. This means you can form a watertight seal by hand. Step 4. Installing the water filter. Now we turn to the filter unit. This has to be situated inside a cupboard, as long-term light exposure can degrade the plastic sump. You should have already determined where the unit will be placed, so now it's simply a case for marking position for the two support screws. You can use the bracket as a guide. Screw in the screws, leaving enough room for the bracket to go back on later. Now take the free end of the water inlet cable and screw it into the stop valve and tighten by hand with the nut runner, being careful not to over-tighten it. We now attach the hose taking filtered water to the tap by pushing the grey push stem elbow firmly into the outlet on top of the filter unit. If you find the back panel is too thin to mount the filter, you should strengthen it by using a wooden batten. Step 5. Installing the plastic vent assembly. When installing the vent assembly, the pipe must be installed vertically and should not be modified in any way. The saddle clamp can fit vertically or on a horizontal section of the pipe. Separate the two halves by unscrewing the four nuts. If you're installing the 41mm pipe, you can throw away the two black rubber inserts, but keep them for the 32mm. Replace the saddle clamp in the chosen position. Tighten securely, screw the vent assembly into the clamp. If you're installing it on a vertical section, you'll need to screw in an elbow first. Insert the pipe cutter into the clamp and cut a hole by turning to the right until you break through. Finally, take the vent hose, that's the one with the black indicator, and connect to the top of the unit, using the supplied nut runner and tighten it by hand. Step 6. Install the boiler. To speed things up, the flexible hoses are colour-coded. Green is the filtered hose, red is for boiling water, and black goes to the vent. To start, take off the protective caps from these three connectors. With the boiler upright inside the cabinet, take the green hose and carefully place the fat silicone washer inside the nut, before screwing the nut onto the correct inlet. There's a green dot to help you find the right one. Now we do the same with the red boiling water hose, inserting a tapered silicone washer on top of the threaded connection indicated red. Both these nuts should now be tight enough to make a watertight seal, but not over-tightened. Connecting the vent hose is done simply by pushing the white push-fit elbow stem into the outlet on top of the boiler. To tidy all these flexible hoses out of harm's way, use cable ties. Step 7. Install the filter change indicator module. The module takes two AA batteries, so we pop them in, listening for the beep, which tells us they're in correctly. Find a convenient place for the module, making sure it's within easy reach of the cable running from the tap, and then use a self-adhesive Velcro pad to secure in place. Then we simply plug the cables together and look at the LED on the tap. It will glow red, then green, before beeping and then turning off, which tells us that it's job done. The LED lets us know when the filter needs changing by glowing red, while glowing yellow means that the batteries on the module need changing. Step 8, getting the system ready. Now the tap is fully installed. We now have to get it ready for use. First up, we pop in a filter cartridge before turning on the water supply. Next, we need to flush the system. So to do this, simply run the boiling water function for 3 minutes before turning the tap off. At this point, it's a good idea to check for leaks. Plug in the boiler and switch it on. All being well, the top LED will turn green and the little mug logo will turn red to tell you that the water is heating up. Wait for 10 minutes to check that the water is discharging from the vent pipe. If it isn't, switch off the power and use the boiling water function to release the pressure. After about 20 minutes, the mug LED will go green and you should operate the boiling tap function to expel any air out of the system. And that's all there is to it. Congratulations, you've just installed the best tap ever made. If you want to find out how to change the water filter, keep watching. Step 9, changing the filter. First, we shut off the power supply and the water supply to the filter. Press the button on top of the filter to release the pressure, or you won't be able to unscrew the filter canister. Before unscrewing, get ready to catch any water residue and then turn to the left to break the seal. Keep going until it separates from the filter head. If the filter doesn't fall out on its own, press down on top of the mount. Get rid of the old cartridge and the remaining water in the sump. Before fitting the new cartridge, wet the O-seals. Once the cartridge is inside, screw the filter head back into place and the cartridge should engage automatically. All that's left is to run the filtered water until the water runs clear and then turn the power back on. That's it from this Franke Omni Tap installation video. Thanks for watching.